with LiveLoveLatte.net. Thank you for joining us for another organization video. But before we show you how we organize our fridge, I'm going to show you an unorganized fridge.
Okay, the first thing I do is I go from top to bottom, and this top shelf is for our orange juice, milk, and then any other extra drinks. And what I do is I make sure those are the same categories. I wipe them down, wipe down the shelves, and then I go to the next level, and this is where the eggs are, and then this is where my husband's salads and mason jars go. And I just want to thank At Home with Nikki. Hi, Nikki. She gave me a revolutionary idea from her refrigerator organization, and that is to put salad in the mason jars. I've used different types of Tupperwares. I put them in Ziploc, and my husband eats salad every single day. He comes home for lunch, he eats that, he pours it on the plate. And so now but they would always get wilted. But the mason jars was such a revolutionary idea. He loves it. I love it. It's so easy to prepare. And so watch her video if you want to see how that works. And here is my cheese deli drawer. And then, so I just go from top to bottom, making sure everything's put back where it belongs. And then this one has bread. And then here I have pasta leftovers or extra bread. And then on this shelf, I have the leftovers, and these are baskets with handles that I used to have in my pantry, and now they're kind of all over the house, but I have two in here for my leftover shelf. And then this drawer has veggies and fruit, and then the bottom drawer is the meat that we have for the week. And then here on the door I have the butter, and then this is my husband's, call him daddy, grab and go. And obviously we had five guys sometime last week. These will probably be thrown out. And here are some of the mason jars. So, you know, these don't belong here. So every week I do this. I go grocery shop, I do the menu, I go grocery shopping, or I do the Safeway.com. And then it takes me about a half hour to clean the fridge and put everything away. And that's because it's all organized, but you know, during the week we kind of sometimes just shove things in. A lot of it is kind of maintained. It doesn't look that nice right now, but it is still kind of in order. So it only takes me half an hour to actually clean it with soap and water, wipe it down, and put everything back and put the groceries away. And then these are condiments. And this is another idea from At Home with Nikki. She suggested to buy these, make everything look more uniform as far as the condiments. And so I did that. And then here's my shelf for Asian stuff. And I do have some more mason jars for kind of pickled stuff. And then the bottom shelf is for extra drinks. Now, I don't know why I did this. I think I was at Costco. I didn't want to go to another grocery store, but I needed one whipped cream. They come in threes, so now I'm left with three. And if I can't give those away, I'll probably have to throw them, because we don't use that. I think I got that for Cicely's party. And here's a alcoholic beverage that I've kept for Christmas. It's a caramel vodka, and it's yummy. Okay, here's some more. You know, these are more drinks that they haven't finished, and they kind of put it there. The drinks up here are the ones that haven't been opened up yet. Okay, I'm putting on the timer for 30 minutes just to see, or let you see, that it does only take me 30 minutes to clean out the fridge and put the groceries in. Okay, I wanted to show you guys the time. It's 18 minutes and 10 seconds left, so it's been about 12 minutes. And in 12 minutes, this is what I've done. I've been able to wipe down every shelf with soapy water and wipe it dry. Take out any leftovers that we're not going to keep. Straightened up some of the shelves. And then I wanted to show you this. Actually, this one for the drinks, it's an open tote file that you can get at any office supply store. And the reason I do this is because you can see this shelf is not too tall, not too tall. And having this open tote, it allows me to put taller stuff up here without it, you know, when it tilts down, it kind of grabs it. And since it's the door, it's always opening and closing. The other thing is that it keeps the shelf clean, and then I just have to clean the tote itself. And if I want to, if I like had a bunch of drinks that I wanted that I'm refrigerating for maybe, let's say, a party, although these are for open drinks, if I'm doing a party, I can put a bunch of drinks in here to refrigerate it, and then I can grab the whole thing and put it into the ice chest or wherever I'm going to be serving drinks. So that's a tip for you guys there. And I'm gonna finish it up now. Okay, so as you can see here, I have 2 minutes and 19 seconds left. So that's about 28 minutes to clean my fridge and put the food back in and organize. And this is what it looks like now organized. I do this every Monday after grocery shopping. I clean it out, throw away any stuff that is out of date, any leftovers that I know we're not gonna eat anymore. And it stays relatively organized through the week. It's usually by Friday, Saturday when we eat out and we have leftovers that it starts getting jumbled up like what you saw earlier. And here's another thing that At Home with Nikki showed on her video, and I do like it for the orange juice. It's these bottles and it just makes everything look neater. The orange juice, it holds pretty well, but for some reason, the milk, this is organic milk, 2% milk, and the other one is the almond milk, and then a jar, the original carton, because there's still a little bit left. They only seem to stay probably about 10 days at the most, but it does look nicer. And then here's like what I said for beverages. I didn't buy any this week, so it's kind of empty. But back there is the milk jug for the espresso maker, and that milk only stays for no more than a day. So we try to put as very little as possible, whatever we're gonna use for that cup, and try not to put more because it does get wasted. Okay, here on this shelf, I love these egg containers. These are from the Container Store. I had the other one, the cheaper one, but those cracked, and then now I have these, and these are much sturdier and they stack well. And I think this is the Linus brand. But so we love eggs. We always buy organic eggs. My husband eats eggs every day, so we have that. And then here are his salads that I prepare. Like I said, I got this idea from Nikki and Revolutionary. These are just the wide mouth mason jars. I just have the organic spring mix in there, the organic strawberries. He pours it onto a plate, cuts some of the hard-boiled eggs, and then puts on some dressing. So I got 4 of those bottles. And then here are the strawberries, the organic strawberries. I have 3 because I bought 2 cartons. 3 of them I leave the stems on, and then I put it in the mason jar. And then there's one, this is for Cicely. I cut off the stems because she loves strawberries. She just loves to eat them as a snack. And then this bin, I got this bin, this one, this, and a 4th one from Costco for $20. Also, I think it's the Inner Design brand. I think this is Inter Design, not Linus. I'm not sure. But here I keep, you know, like the peanut butter jam, and then there's salsa back here. And so instead of leaving it in the big jar, I put them into 2 smaller mason jars, and it keeps well that way. And the great thing about these bins, well, this top shelf, it slides out. Oops, sorry. It slides out so I can kind of reach in there. These other bins, like this one, it's nice to have them all together. They pull out, they slide out like that. I can get whatever's in there and put it back in. And then here's the deli drawer, pretty much kind of the same. I just put the turkey in there, and then that casein-free cheese. And then down here is the bread. So I have the bread from last week and some mini bagels. And here are the two breads I bought this week, the Ezekiel bread. Now usually all the bread fits in here, but I bought these two at the same in the same week because we go through about a loaf of bread a week. But I bought two because they were on sale and those are kind of expensive. So I bought those. Usually here's another whole space for more leftovers or other pasta. And here, this is one of those 2-liter holders. Holders for the 2-liter sodas. I put it there because, you know, there's a big space in between here. And this just, you know, allows me to have another level of that I can put stuff there. And then, again, these are the storage baskets with handles. These are just leftovers. And I have a few of these Tupperwares. I think they're Glad brand. And I put leftovers in there. Okay, here's the fourth bin that came with that $20 box from Costco. As you can see, it would normally fit in there, but the bread's in there, so for this week I won't be needing this. In the veggies and fruit drawer, I usually, like here, this is where the organic basil, I took it out of the container that it came in because that usually takes up more space. And this one, oh, this is Rubbermaid, not Glad. So this one is just takes up a little bit less space and they stack decently. This one has the broccolini, the two packages of broccolini in there. I have another one of these Rubbermaid containers and I could put these in there, but I think it's enough space. I didn't need, you know, I didn't have to create more space, so I left it in there. And then down here you can see all the protein that we bought this week, which was, here's the hot Italian sausage, lobster tails, ribeye steak, boneless skinless chicken breast, and ground beef. So that's what's going to be on the menu this week, which is for the ground beef, I'm doing some spaghetti and meatballs, ribeye steak and broccolini, lobster claw is one night, and then boneless skinless chicken breast, my husband puts it on his salad, or we can eat that standalone. Okay, then up here is the butter. Yeah, that butter looks kind of funky, huh? But anyway, I took the wrapper off, and then I usually put the butter like that and see, so I can see how many sticks are left. It's easy to see and I know when I need to add more onto the shopping list. And then here is his grab and go. Those are hard boiled eggs. I need to boil a few more, although he usually does it every week. Once in a while I'll help him out, but he has that every day. Here's a couple more jars with the organic spring mix and strawberry. So there's four here, there's two here, so that's six. Here are some blueberries to go that I just picked up. And then here are the condiments, the ones that condiment holders that Nikki had recommended. And you can see it does look so much cleaner and neater. Down here I got rid of, I think, a yogurt and a pico de gallo that was expired. Oh, I gotta show you this. If you're Filipino, you know what this is. It's salted fish sauce. It's just anchovies. Let me see if you can see that. Yeah, can you see the eyeballs? Anyway, either you're gonna be grossed out or you'll think it's fascinating. And then we do have wasabi. Okay, so this is my Asian, and I do have pickles here. So that's that shelf or that bin. And down here I got rid of some frosting. I did keep this for now, but hopefully I can give those away. Okay, so that's how we organize our fridge. As you can see, it looks so much better. And that only took 30 minutes every week. That takes only 30 minutes every week. And I think the great part is once you have a system that works for you, it will stay organized. It's just a matter of cleaning and putting things away and throwing things out. Okay, take care and we'll see you in the next video.
Thanks for watching LiveLoveLatte.net. You can also find us on Facebook, Twitter, Pinterest, and Instagram.